Let's jump into submarines. That detail out today, 5 Virginia class, those are the US nuclear submarines. We will buy them to have a capability gap breach between our Collins class and the ones that we will build in Australia, the British Astute class. So the Virginia will bridge those two submarine classes. A lot of debate, though, about the nitty-gritty from here on in. Can we have the technology, the PhDs, the extra workers, the submariners required to crew, operate and maintain these boats in Australia? What does it all mean? I mean, it's a big ramp up. It's a lot of money. Can we do it? Let's bring in someone who'll give us some details here. Senior analyst at the Australian Strategic Policy Institute, Dr. Malcolm Davis. I've got to have an important caveat. This is still not official in terms of announcement, but the details out there in the media. Give us your sense of this decision to go with the Virginia class and the Astute.
Okay, so what the arrangement is that in 2027, the US will forward deploy or home port nuclear submarines out of Western Australia in anticipation that Australia would, in the early 2030s, get between 3 and 5 of the Block 5 Virginia class, which is the current US Navy nuclear-powered submarine. These would then allow us to transition to a follow-on to the Astute class, which is called the SSNR. And essentially what it would mean is by getting those Virginia-class boats, we close that strike gap, that capability gap that we would have had had we tried to go straight from the Collins-class diesel-electric submarines, which we have now, to the SSNR in the late 2040s. We have that nuclear capability much, much earlier.
Give us your assessment of the Virginia class. I mean, they are regarded as the most sophisticated man-made entity acquisition on the planet. What do you think about them?
Look, they are, you're quite correct, they are the most advanced nuclear-powered submarine in service. Essentially, they are extremely quiet, and in submarine warfare, quietness is gold. Quietness is victory. So they are the apex predator of the ocean in the sense that they can enjoy high speed, long endurance on station, much longer than what the Collins-class diesel-electric submarines have. They do not need to surface on a regular basis to recharge their engines. They can remain underwater for months on end. Their only limitation is basically the amount of food on board. So they are fully equipped with a range of advanced weapons. The Block 5 Virginias, which we'll probably be getting, have what's known as VLS, or Vertical Launch System, which is full of missile capabilities that can attack targets on land and also at sea. So we will be getting very advanced nuclear-powered submarines that will allow us to then transition across to these new SSNRs, probably in the late 2030s.
Malcolm, we're told, you know, we have trouble now getting the submariners needed to get the Collins-class boats, even if they're, you know, well-maintained, into the water. We know they've had issues in the past with some of their internal mechanical problems, but let's assume here we go with these much larger US boats, they'll need far more personnel. And then to have an industry in Australia, in Adelaide, building this new British class, the Astute class, which will come down the track, all the expertise that's required, yes, we've got time to scale up, but this is a mammoth task, isn't it?
It is, but these are challenging times. We are in a pre-war period where we're seeing a rising China that is determined to impose a degree of hegemony across the Indo-Pacific region, in particular to take Taiwan against the willingness of the Taiwanese people to become part of the PRC. So we are living in dangerous times, and I think, you know, the DSR and also AUKUS is really designed to respond to that challenge. So yes, we do have some real challenges in terms of workforce, particularly in terms of shipbuilding, to establish that, to build the SSNR boats that are later in the 2030s. But it's a step we have to take. If we don't do this, we simply won't be ready for the types of strategic risks and tactical risks that we face.